Starry, starry night, paint your palette blue and gray. Look out.
Greetings and salutations, all my YouTubians, Odysseans, Slayensayans, Cobra Kais, and all my pumpkins that are smashing. I am Original Asherella. This is Original Asherella. And last night we did the final farewell tribute Creem Streem to Irate Prostate. You probably already know that Irate passed away week before last. He was our host and fearless leader and a really beloved person on this side of the internet and in these internet circles. And last night's stream was very emotional, and parts of it were kind of hard, but we had so many great stories. It was a chance for people to come on and do, instead of doing 2 minutes of hate, they did 2 minutes to Irate. And, you know, people could come on and eulogize, so to speak, and share a story or, you know, some feelings about Irate that they had. And we got so many good stories. There was a lot of shared sentiment in the you know, stories that we heard last night, but I think last night's stream was just kind of a snapshot of all of the people that Irate had impacted over the years, or, you know, that had made a difference in their life over the years. And I think we can all agree that, you know, my life is genuinely a little better because I knew Irate, and, you know, I was privileged enough to, like, work with him, you know, because he was really just a genuinely cool and fun and funny and entertaining and talented and just a really good guy. And it just doesn't seem fair because there's so many not good guys out there in the world. And it, why do they have to take, why does a good one have to be taken from us, you know? And I could go on about that for a while, but the stream last night was really great. If you missed it, I'll link the stream down in the description. It was on Trippy's channel. It was great, and I think, you know, it really just showed how many people cared about Irate and that he cared about in return. There was such an outpouring of love for Irate and to Uzi, his wife, last night. And just to make sure you keep Uzi close to your heart and in your thoughts. I can't imagine what she's going through right now, because I know the way I feel, and that's only a tiny fraction of, I'm sure, what she's going through. And if I can, you know, repeat myself in, or kind of reiterate a couple things that I said in my 2 minutes to Irate last night, is that, you know, Irate and I had been kind of in the same internet circles for the past couple years, but it wasn't until he asked me to do the ice cream interview that we really got to talk in and got to know each other. And whenever he first reached out to ask me, I was like, yes, definitely. Like, I would consider it an honor to do an ice cream interview. And I am so genuine when I say that. Like, I was so excited, and I thought it was so cool that of all the people out there, he wanted to interview me, you know? And I had such a great time doing the interview. It was so much fun, and it flew by, and, like, the whole time, you know, we joked and laughed, and it got a little deep, and it got a little funny, and I said like a lot, like I always do, but it was such a good time, and Irate was so good at interviewing people, and you could really tell that he really enjoyed doing that. But then shortly after the ice cream interview, he reached out and asked if I wanted to be a full-time Creem Streamer, like if I wanted to be on the panel full-time. And I was like, yes, hell yes. Are really me? Like, you want me to be on your show full-time? Because, you know, I mean, this is a stream and a streamer and a content creator that I really look up to and I respected so much. And the other panelists are, you know, people that I kind of aspire to be like. And so to be asked to be among them, I just felt so privileged, and I still do. And, you know, I was the newest person on the show, but the past several months that I had been on, I have loved every single minute of it. It was such a great time, and it's an experience that I will value for the rest of my life. A Tim of the Hun had made a comment last night that really just reminded me of that feeling that I had when he asked me to be on the show full time, about how, you know, he really put a lot of thought and contemplation into the people that he brought on to his shows and involved in his work. And God, that just made me, you know, just knowing that made me feel even better. And I think I remember, if I look way back in the DMs when he first asked me, I think he said something about how, like, the vibes just felt right, or the chemistry was really good with me. And I don't disagree. I feel like, you know, everybody on the panel and Irate, like, we just, you know, I'm not like any of the others. They're not like any of the others. And we all just kind of worked off each other and bounced off each other really well together. And we had a lot of different personalities on the show. And I know there were even more, many more personalities on the Creem Streem throughout the years. But it's really been a great experience. And I hate that it was cut so tragically short. Yeah, and so that's kind of just my thoughts on Irate in the stream last night. Irate's a great guy, and we will miss you. And today, right now, here in just a second, we're going to be listening to a Smashing Pumpkins song that always brings me a little bit of extra comfort whenever someone I care about passes away. It's actually the song for Martha. Billy Corgan wrote this song when his mother Martha passed away in 1996, and it's off the album Adore. It is a song about a passing and losing a loved one, but it's not depressing. It's comforting in a way, and I think you'll see what I mean when we listen to it, and we're gonna do that in just a minute. But before I do, subscribe to the channel on YouTube, follow the channel on ODYSEE, gently press the notification bell on either platform, leave me a like, leave me a comment, and you can follow me on my social media accounts. I have Instagram and I have Twitter. Now I think I know. This is the Smashing Pumpkins for Martha for Irate. We'll see if I can get through it. The song has a pretty long intro and instrumental track at the start before the lyrics start. And the piano part, it really kind of like feels like a roller coaster. You know, it takes you up and down and up and down, and is definitely like you can feel the emotion going up and down in it. I said the song is a song that kind of brings me comfort when someone I care about is lost, and that is true, but it doesn't come without bringing out emotions. To the instrumental track that we're going through in this song, you know, we have that piano part that brings you up and down, and then you have like the rhythm section, you know, like the bass and the percussion that kind of gently come in, and it's a comforting sound. Like it's like a warm, deep layer that it adds that makes you feel a little comforted if that makes sense. It's the one that really draws the tears. It says, if you have to go, don't say goodbye. If you have to go, don't you cry. If you have to go, I will get by. Someday I'll follow you and see you on the other side. And I know you're not supposed to cry. Like, that's what it's saying. And it's like, when we lose someone we care about, or a loved one, or a friend, I think most of them wouldn't want us to sit around in mourning forever. But it's hard to not just feel that loss so deeply. Never says, but for the grace of love, I'd wield the meaning of heaven from above. And during the stream last night, it was talked about so much, just about how good of a guy Irate was, and you know, how much love that he shared and he showed everyone in his life, and no one more than his wife, Uzi. And there was definitely, like, a grace to his love for her. And she's such a great woman. And, like I said earlier, I can't imagine, like, the feelings that she's having right now. It's impacted all of us so much, and I'm getting rambly, I'm sorry. But for the grace of love, I will the meaning of heaven from above. Your picture out of time, love taking. That verse says, your picture out of time left aching in my mind, shadows kept alive. And someone last night on the stream said that you have two passings, one when your body physically dies, and then another one when the last person has a thought of you for the last time. And that verse kind of reminds me of that, because it's like, despite Irate or any of our other loved ones being gone, we still hold them in our mind, you know, and our memories of them are left in our mind. And I honestly can say it will be many, many generations before people aren't still thinking of Irate, you know, maybe even longer than that. Like, I don't know if you can memorialize a YouTube channel, but if that is something that can be done, I think we should definitely look into it, because he just had so much great content that hopefully people will continue to discover.
If you have to go, don't say goodbye. If you have to go, don't you cry. If you have to go, I will goodbye. I will follow you and see you on the other side.
It's kind of ironic that the line "Don't you cry" is the line that makes me cry the most. Back to the musical track on this song. You know, we have that, you know, really kind of like floaty melodic sounding part, and then the drama comes back in. And I kind of equate that to like the feelings you have when someone passes. You know, you get emotional and you get angry and you get sad, and then you kind of get nostalgic and reminiscent and it feels better, but then, you know, all of those same emotions cycle through. You know, anytime anybody that I care about, you know, passes away, it's like I don't just cry one time, and I don't just laugh at memories I had of them one time, and I don't just get angry about it one time. It's like I do those things almost in a cycle, and I feel like the musical track of this kind of is replicating those emotions, at least for me. Wouldn't be a great Smashing Pumpkins track if you didn't have like a burst of badass guitar, you know? This song really has so many feelings in it, and I mean, it changes, like, the tempo changes, and instrument changes, and just overall feelings and vibe throughout the song are just crazy, you know? Like, it really is kind of all over the place, and it's crazy. Like, I love Billy Corgan so much, because I know this is probably just for me, but, like, the Smashing Pumpkins and his songwriting are literally, like, musical representations of my emotional life. The CD's not skipping. I promise. Remember that back in the day when the CDs would skip? I actually really love this part because, you know, you have that repeating, you know, fade out, and then you get this crescendo back up with this kind of chaotic, all over the place kind of sound and feeling. And again, I think this is definitely an emotion and a feeling that we deal with whenever we do lose someone we love. How sometimes you just feel like emotions all over the place and you're in a little bit of emotional chaos with the loss of a loved one. Okay, that was For Martha by the Smashing Pumpkins. Again, like I said in the beginning, Billy Corgan wrote that song when his mother Martha passed away. I think she died of cancer, and that was like back in like the middle, late 90s. But this was on the album Adore. And, you know, I really just think it's a great song that does... And I guess, like, knowing that it was written for, like, when someone was in kind of a time of mourning, you know, I don't know if that's why I get the feels that I do from the song, like, knowing that, or if I didn't know that, if the song would still make me feel this way. But either way, I do get some comfort in it because especially, you know, like I said, the lines in the song that, like, that's telling you, don't you cry, and that's how our loved ones would want us to feel, are the parts that make me cry the most. But again, you know, it says, if you have to go, don't say goodbye. If you have to go, don't you cry. If you have to go, I will get by. Someday I'll follow you and see you on the other side. And so it's almost like a conversation back and forth. And, you know, despite whatever your religious beliefs or spiritual beliefs or, you know, whatever you think happens next, I like to think, you know, this isn't it, and that when we lose people, we will see them again. At least I hope, you know. I'm not gonna say too much more because I could ramble on and on. You know me if you watch the channel, but I am Asherella. This is Original Asherella. If you don't already subscribe to the channel, please subscribe to the channel. You can also follow the channel on ODYSEE. Leave me a like, leave me a comment, follow me on my social media accounts. I have Instagram and I have Twitter. Also catch me on Sundays on Twitch on Original Asherella, my Twitch channel, for Kino and Commentary. That's where we watch movie and commentate, and it's a really good time. It's a fun show. It's a fun stream, and we watch a movie and, you know, make jokes, and it's a really good time. So check that out. I'll link that down in the description also. And that's about it, guys. If you did not get a chance to watch the final Creem Streem, our tribute stream to Irate Prostate. Make sure you check that out. That will be down in the description as well. That's on Trippy's channel. I don't know if I said that earlier, but the link will be down there. I'm going to stop talking. Always tap in. Never tap out. And don't forget to keep on slaying like a Saiyan. Cyber fam.
The ragged men in ragged clothes, a silver thorn, a bloody rose, lie crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you